to play a beautiful and tough battle in the 5G era, established HiSilicon, and the Kirin chip developed by it once became the world's leading 5G SoC. However, due to the increasingly fierce Sino-US trade war, Huawei's ability to erode the market share of Western companies in many fields has made some people particularly jealous, which eventually led to the revision of chip rules and Huawei's inability to obtain the authorization of Google's GMS. In overseas markets, Google's Android system occupies an absolutely leading market advantage, especially Google's YouTube, Google Map, Chrome, and other applications, which are favored by the majority of overseas users. Therefore, in overseas markets, whether it is a brand mobile phone such as Xiaomi, Oppo, Vivo, or Huawei, the Google GMS service is pre-installed at the factory. When Google did not allow Huawei to use GMS services, Huawei's harmonyos system accelerated the launch of the harmonyos mobile phone system. At the same time, Huawei also launched its self-developed application ecosystem HMS overseas. According to overseas media reports, Google plans to use Huawei's EROFS as the default file system for the Android 13 system partition, and pre-installed Android 13 and integrates the complete Google GMS suite of devices. With the blessing of Huawei's EROFS system, it will bring smoother performance. System experience. Google doesn't let Huawei use GMS services, but secretly uses Huawei's EROFS file management system. Why? Next you will see. 1. Why did Huawei invent HarmonyOS? 2. Why does Google not use GMS services for Huawei, but secretly use Huawei's technology? 3. Why did Google change its attitude towards Huawei? Why did Huawei invent HarmonyOS? Since it was no longer possible to entrust TSMC to manufacture Kirin chips in 2019, Huawei mobile phones have been in decline. The P50 series and Nova 9 series released last year are all 4G mobile phones, and the use of 5G networks has to rely on third-party manufacturers to launch 5G mobile phone cases. The Kirin chip is gone, and 5G is not yet supported. In desperation, Huawei can only regularize the self-developed HarmonyOS system in advance, making HarmonyOS a trump card that differentiates Huawei's mobile phones from other mobile phones. HarmonyOS, which has invested a lot of money and manpower in development, did not disappoint. Since the official release of HarmonyOS 2 in June last year, more than 200 million mobile phones have been upgraded with the HarmonyOS 2 system. The new version of the HarmonyOS 3 system is also expected to debut around July. Series debut. The rapid development of HarmonyOS has worried Android parent company Google. Because the core code of HarmonyOS is more streamlined than Android, it is more fluent. Some digital media have compared HarmonyOS and iOS, and believe that the two are comparable in experience. However, HarmonyOS also has its weaknesses. As a new system, the ecology of HarmonyOS is definitely far inferior to that of Android. It can only gradually improve the ecology through compatibility with Android apps. Therefore, most of the apps in the HMS, Huawei Mobile Services, application market are still Android app. It was previously reported that in order to limit the development of HarmonyOS and crack down on HMS applications, Google has informed application developers not to upload SDKs, software development kits, with HMS. If developers don't follow suit, Google will forcefully take down their apps. Many people think that the system of Huawei mobile phones will be all in HarmonyOS in the future. In fact, this is not the case. The HarmonyOS system is currently only for domestic users. In overseas markets, Huawei mobile phones are still using the Android system. This move is also to take care of the usage habits of overseas users. Huawei's global official website shows that the EMUI based on the Android kernel is still being updated. Last year, EMUI 12 was launched and used on Nova 9 and other models. Why does Google not use GMS services for Huawei, but secretly use Huawei's technology? As we all know, EMUI is not like the operating system of some mobile phone manufacturers. It is just a UI on top of the Android kernel, and there are still some self-developed technologies. Today, Huawei's self-developed core technology has been recognized by Google. At the Google I/O Developer Conference on May 12, Google officially released the Android 13 system and announced the first models to support the Android 13 beta. In order to close the gap with the iOS experience again, the Android 13 system has made many upgrades, such as through the special optimization of virtual memory management and manslaughter background, so that the mobile phone can reduce the background manslaughter by 85% when the memory is occupied by 75%. According to the latest reports from foreign media, in the official version of Android 13 system, Google's default file system will use the EROFS super file system developed by Huawei, the ARC compiler, to achieve a faster startup speed, allowing mobile phones to quickly read files at the same time. It can also save space. Since EMUI 9, EROFS super file system technology has been popularized in Huawei mobile phones. At the Huawei P30 series conference in April 2019, Huawei officially launched the ARC compiler, which is the Huawei super file system EROFS that will be used in the official version of Android 13. According to Yuqing Dong, CEO of Huawei's consumer business, the ARC compiler solves the inefficiency problems of the Android system, as well as the smoothness and lag problems, improving the system operation fluency by 20%, the system response time by 44%. And the three-party application operation fluency by 60%. Yuqing Dong also said that developers do not need to redevelop the application, but only need to compile, and the execution speed can be improved. At the same time, he announced that the Huawei ARC compiler is open source for the industry, and hopes that app developers can use it as soon as possible. After a lapse of 3 years, Google is finally going to use the ARC compiler. Although it is long overdue, it can be regarded as a high recognition of Huawei's technological development capabilities. From cracking down on HMS-compatible Android apps to the official version of Android 13 using Huawei's core technology, the ARC compiler, Google's attitude has undergone a 180-degree change. This also shows that Huawei has done a good job in optimizing both harmonyos and Android. Why has Google changed its attitude towards Huawei? Different from Apple's closed iOS system, both Android and harmonyos are open source. In the case of the increasingly bloated Android system, Android 13 is equipped with the open source ARC compiler, which can not only effectively improve the fluency and user experience of Android 13, but also it can also help Google significantly save development costs, which Google must be happy to accept. After Huawei was sanctioned, domestic mobile phone manufacturers realized the importance of self-developed technology. Oppo and Xiaomi have launched their own Mariana chips and surging C1/P1 chips, and self-developed mobile phone SoC chips are also in an orderly manner, keeping the core technology firmly in their hands. When the technology and time are ripe, it will follow Huawei and replace the supply of Qualcomm/MediaTek/Samsung with self-developed chips. Yuqing Dong said at the launch of Huawei's new folding screen Mate XS2 that Huawei's supply chain has been greatly improved, and anyone who wants to buy Huawei mobile phones can buy them in the future. Recent news shows that the Nova 10 series is about to be released, and the Mate 50 series is coming soon. Coupled with Google's change in Huawei's attitude, Huawei's mobile phone is expected to return ahead of schedule. From the content, we know. 1. Why did Huawei invent harmonyos? 2. Why does Google not use GMS services for Huawei, but secretly use Huawei's technology? 3. Why did Google change its attitude towards Huawei? In a short, Google Android 13 has introduced Huawei's EROFS file system. It also confirms that domestic production is no longer synonymous with backwardness in the field of operating systems. As long as we jointly build the ecology, we will definitely be able to promote the domestic system to a better future. I also hope that other domestic mobile phone manufacturers can also stick to the road of self-development, get rid of the status quo of being technically controlled by others, and make domestic products self-improvement.